Ho 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 everyone, my name is Joan and the holidays are upon us and I wanted to share some of my favorite films that you might enjoy this season. This list is going to include some movies that are wacky, weird, and wonderful. These films have been close to my heart and they have the themes of the holidays, so I think you might be able to enjoy them. Let's get started. The first movie on this list is called Holiday in Handcuffs. This stars Melissa Joan Hart and Mario Lopez as an unlikely duo who has to survive Christmas together. Now the catch is that Melissa Joan Hart kidnaps Mario Lopez because she's having a nervous breakdown. Honestly, this film does have a wacky premise, but it does feel very cheeky. I love me a good dysfunctional family, and this family is very all over the place. But the holiday spirit is live. I think what I like about this film so much is that, like, in the end, Melissa Joan Hart and Mario Lopez do get together, like, every Christmas miracle, but, like, the choice, like, turns because Mario Lopez's character gets saved, but then, like, when he has the option to charge everyone for kidnapping, he doesn't. And so it's like, oh, you do have a good heart. And like, it's kind of funny because Melissa Joan Hart's character is so like messy of a character and she's just like the black sheep. Mario Lopez's character actually feels bad for her. And so it's just like, that's so depressing. How is your victim, your kidnapping victim, gonna feel bad for you? Honestly, this has been one of my favorites for years. Like, I just love it. It's stupid, but it's great. The next movie on my list is Die Hard, because this is a Christmas movie and you can't tell me otherwise. This film is about John McClane, a New York City detective who comes to LA to rekindle his romance with his estranged wife. Now he gets invited to a Christmas Eve party at Nakatomi Tower, and let's say some unpleasant guests crash the party and John McClane has to save the day. If you've been under a rock since 1980-something, Die Hard has been one of those movies that are debatable if it's a Christmas movie or not. And honestly, I think it's a Christmas movie because A, it takes place during Christmas, B, it has all the themes of Christmas, family, love, estrangement, rekindling stuff, being yourself, all the things you need for Christmas. And it has hot people, which includes young Bruce Willis. And I don't know, I don't remember the actress who played Holly Gennaro, but she can get it too. They both can get this body. I love Die Hard. Die Hard is just one of those movies that you just get it or you don't. It's pure action. It's pure octane. You have Professor Snape in there, sprinkled in there. You got fun little one-liners. What more can you want? The next film on this list is Home Alone 2, Lost in New York. What can I say about this movie that already has not been said? This is a classic, a holiday classic. The best Home Alone in the whole franchise. Even though they just came out with a new one like last year, this year, it doesn't matter. All you need is the first two and that's it. Honorable mention does go out to Home Alone 3, but that's it, okay? This movie has funny quotes, timeless quotes, scenes, Kevin McAllister doing his thing by pranking the same people who try to get him the first time. I love this movie. It is a classic, and there's not much I can say. Just watch it this holiday season for nostalgia. That's it. The next movie on my list is The Ultimate Christmas Present. Now, are you thinking, Joan, did you name your video after this film? And the answer is yes. Yes, I did, because this film is probably my favorite Christmas film ever, and it's the only DCOM that I watch yearly. The plot of this film is a whole other story, and let me just give the basic cliff notes of it. This movie is about Hallie, who steals a weather machine from Santa and uses it to snow in LA. In doing that, it prevents her father from getting home, and she learns gratitude and the aspect of family as a lesson, but also not to steal from Santa, or you will be on the bad list. But also, if you do need Santa's help, he will help you. This movie's crazy, okay? You have two elves, one of them being a basketball player, okay? But another thing about this movie is that you have a young Brenda Song in it. Brenda Song was on that Disney Channel. She reigned that channel, okay? Honestly, I just love this film. This film just reminds me of childhood, and it reminds me of how much family means to me, especially during the holidays. And I think they tackled the theme very well. And it makes my heart warm. But also, the antagonist of this film is a weatherman, and I think that's fucking weird. And that concludes my small but personal list of films that I watch every holiday season, and I think that you should watch too. I love the holiday season, and I love being in the spirit. This year, I'm actually gonna watch the classic movies from the 40s with my boyfriend, and I think it's gonna be a grand time. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.